Hello students, today I will present on the topic of introduction to livestock production and management in the subject of livestock production and management, in which I will include the scope of livestock in Indian economy, trends in livestock production, then general information about different livestock animals, the different livestock development programs in government of India and different breeds of livestock animals. First, the scope of livestock in Indian economy, livestock census, trends in livestock production. The livestock production performance has been more impressive than that of food grain production. The milk, egg, fish, meat showed the impressive growth rates of about 5 to 10%. The minimum targeted growth rate for attaining self-sufficiency in milk, fish, meat and egg by 2001 AD are around 5.54, 6.25 and 5.54 per annum respectively. The livestock represents the only way in which the natural vegetation that covers large parts of India can be converted into the products that can be used by men. It provides the draft power and also the manure to the crop enterprise, and this in turn provides the feed and fodder. Fortunately, India is blessed with tremendous livestock wealth. It has the largest population of cattle and buffalo in the world, and its breeds are admired for heat tolerance and inherent resistance to diseases and ability to thrive under different climate conditions. The cattle population of India is very large, and according to 1991 census, the cattle population was estimated at around 467.9 million. This comprised of about 203.1 million cattle, 83.1 million buffaloes, 50.7 million sheep, 115.3 million goats and around 12.1 million pigs, and the others were estimated around 3.6 million. The poultry population consists of around 400 million. First is the milk production. The India ranks first in the milk production for about 132 million tons per annum in the year of 2012. This has been the achievement of the 70 million dairy farmers, and also through the state efforts of the animal husbandry practices, cattle crossbreeding projects and also the cooperative dairy farming. It is worthwhile to mention that as per capita availability of milk to the lacto-vegetarian Indian is estimated around 290 gram per day in the year of 2012. It has been the only source of sufficient energy, minerals, vitamins and animal proteins. A 60% of total milk production enters to the market in the form of dahi, butter, ghee, khoa and srikhand, and also other dairy products like milk powder, ice cream and also in cheese. During the last 20 years, the supply of milk has been possible in sufficient quantities through the pasteurization plant and also through the chilling centers. The animal draft power. The bullock pair may be regarded as the backbone of Indian agriculture. Though the animal draft power does not relate with human nutrition directly, indirectly it contributes to the production of food grains. The renowned draft animals like cattle and buffalo include various breeds of cattle and buffalo like Khilar, Amrit Mahal and etc. There are about 86 million draft animals, which comprise of 76 million bullocks, 8 million buffaloes and 1 million camels and donkeys. The horsepower obtained from one bullock is equivalent to the 0.75 horsepower. Mechanization in agriculture has been to the tune of 20% only, whereas 80% of the agriculture or farm operation are done by bullock-driven implements. Milk production in India. The flesh foods are rich in protein and are good source of vitamin B12, which is absent in the plant food. The India's meat production is around 3%, which is 6.3 million tons of the 3% of the global milk production, and the global milk production is around 220 million tons in the year of 1995. And out of the meat produced in the India, that is 54% is from mutton and chicken, 26% from beef, 13% from chicken and 7% from the pork. Even though the 70% of India's population consume meat, The per capita availability of milk is only less than 5 kg per year. The poultry industry has achieved a spectacular growth during the last 30 years. The 24 billion eggs produced in 1991 represented 30-fold increase compared to in the year of 1951. With the annual production of 27 billion eggs in the 1995 to 96, India stands fifth in the world in meat production. The government has promoted the poultry development through the intensive poultry development project launched in the third fiber plant during the year of 1969 to 1974. The improved breeds like RIR, WLH and Australia, the per capita availability of egg in India is only 55 per annum in the year of 2012 as against the ICMR recommendation, that is about 180 per year. Next is the fish production. Fish is the cheap source of animal protein, but it is the good source of calcium. The fish production of India risen to 4.95 million tons in the year of 1995 to 1996. The per capita availability of fish in 1996 was 5.4 kg, whereas the ICMR recommendation is around 10.95 kg per annum. The farm yard manure for organic farming. A minimum of 10 to 20 kg dung is obtained on an average from every cow and buffalo, and this is the excellent source of farm yard manure or compost manure, and this is the badly needed to improve the inherent soil fertility and to have the excellent mineral effect on the crop parts. It is estimated that 640 million tons of cow dung is being utilized to meet the household fuel requirements. And besides, the cow dung and poultry dropping can also be better utilized for in the organic manner. Next is the employment generation. The animal husbandry and dairying may be regarded as the source to create the employment in rural areas all around the year in India, and the Indian agriculture is mainly dependent on monsoon, and hence the agriculture field face the certain bullet lengths to the provide employment during this period. And average agriculture sector may provide 200 days employment to the rural person. This means they have to find alternate source for the income. The dairying farming, sheep, goat rearing, poultry production, pig farming, rabbit rearing are the alternate source of milk farming, and this is the source of other income. It may be possible to generate the employment for the farm as well as landless laborers who can do this job themselves, or it may be possible to employ young and the old family person as a side business. And many of the operations in animal husbandry and poultry farming can be done by the rural women, and it is estimated that on an average 35 million human employment generation has been potential through this sector. This is the general information of different livestock animals, for example buffalo, goat, sheep, horn, ass. The male cow is, the male cattle is called cow, and the female cattle is called cow, and the male cattle is called bull, and so on for the duck, ass and other livestock animals. The different livestock development programs in the government of India. There are the Dairy Entrepreneurship Development Scheme, then Intensive Dairy Development Program, Fodder and Feed Development Scheme, Pig Development Scheme, Poultry Venture Capital Fund, Establishment and Modernization of Rural Sturger Houses, Savages and Rearing of Male Buffalo Cows, Utilization of Fallen Animals, the Integrated Development of Small Ruminants, that are sheep and goats and the rabbits, the Conservation of Threatened Breeds of Small Ruminants, Rabbits, Pigs, Pack Animals and Equines, and the Livestock Insurance Scheme. Next topic is the breed of cattle. The indigenous breeds is classified in mainly three types. First is the milch breed, is also called the milk breed. Second is the dual purpose breed, and third one is the draft breed. First is milk breed. The cows are higher milk yields, and the male animals are slow or poor work animals. And the example of the milk breeds are Sahiwal, Red Sindhi, Gir, and Dioni. and the milk production in this type of milk breeds is on an average around 1600 kg per lactation. The second type is the dual purpose breed. In this type of breed, the cows are average milk yielder and male animals are very useful for the work. The milk production for the dual purpose breed is on an average around 500 to 1500 kg per lactation. An example of dual purpose breeds are Ongole, Haryana, Kankrej, Tharpakar, Krishnavele, Rathi and Goala Mewati. The third type of breed is the draft breed. These type of animals are, male animals are good for work and cows are poor milk yielders. The milk yield are less than 500 kg per lactation and they are usually white in color and a pair of bullock can fuel around 1000 kg net with an iron type cart on good road at walking speed of around 5 to 7 km per hour and they cover the distance of around 30 to 40 km per day. And twice as much weight can be pulled on pneumatic rubber tube carts. And the example for this dog breed are Kangyanam, Amlicheri, Amrit Mahal and Helliker. We see the details about different breeds of cattle. The first, we see the indigenous cattle breeds, in which the milk breeds, the first is Red Sindhi. This type, the Red Sindhi breed of cattle is mainly from the Kohistan and Sindh province in present Pakistan. And it is the most distinctive cattle breed of India. And this breed of cattle is mainly available in Punjab, Haryana, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Orissa. And under the good management conditions, the Red Sindhi average around 1700 kg of milk after sucking their cows, but under optimum condition, they have been milk yields of on an average around 3400 kg per lactation. The second one is the Sahiwal. It is originally belonging to the Montgomery district of Pakistan. It is mainly found in Punjab, Haryana, UP, Delhi, Bihar and MP in India. The milk yield under village condition for Sahiwal breed is around 1350 kg and under commercial condition it is around 1200 kg milk yield. The age at first calving for this breed is 32 to 36 months and the calving interval is around 15 months. The third breed is Gir. This breed of cattle is mainly found in Gir area of Gujarat and the Gir cows are good milk yielder. And the milk yield under village condition is around 900 kg but under commercial farm it is around 1600 kg. The second type of the cattle breed is milk and draft breed, that is dual purpose breed. In that the first is Haryana. This type of breed is mainly found in Karnal, Hisar and Gurgaon district of Haryana, Delhi and western Madhya Pradesh. The milk yield for the Haryana breed of cattle is around 1140 to 4500 kg. And the bullocks of this breed are powerful for road transport and rapid plugging. Second is the Tharpakar breed. This is mainly found in Jodhpur, Kutch and Jaisalmer in the India. And the milk yield for this breed under village condition is around 1660 kg but under commercial farm the milk yield is around 2500 kg. The third type of breed under this is the Kankrej. This type of breed is mainly found in Gujarat and the milk yield for this breed under village condition is 1300 kg and under commercial condition it is 3600 kg. And the age at first calving for this Kankrej breed is around 36 to 42 months and the calving interval is around 15 to 16 months. And the bullocks of these Kankrej breeds are fast, active and strong and they are good for plug and cart purpose. Second, the last type is the draft breed. Under this, the first breed of cattle is Kangyanam. This breed in its native is also known the other names like Kanganad and Kongu. And these cattle are bred in the southern and southern eastern area of Euro district of Tamil Nadu in India. And this is the mainly found in Coimbatore, Erode, Karur Dingle district of the Tamil Nadu and best suited for the plugging and transport, and this breed is withstand the hardy condition in any of the hard condition. The second type under the draft breed is the Amrit Mahal. This breed is mainly found in India in Karnataka and it is best suitable for plugging and transport. And the third breed under the draft breed is Helicon. It is mainly found in Tumkur, Hassan and Mysore district of Karnataka. And the bullocks of these breeds are strong, well spirited, quick and steady in the field as well as on the road. Next is the exotic breeds of the cattle, in which the first breed is the Jersey. The origin for Jersey breed is this breed was developed from the Iceland of Jersey in France. The distinguishing characteristics for Jersey breed are as under. The Jersey is one of the oldest dairy breeds, having been reported by authorities as being purveyed for nearly 6 countries. The color in Jersey may vary from the grey or mouse color to very dark fawn or shade that is almost black. The age at first calving for this Jersey breed is around 26 to 30 months. The intercalving period is around 13 to 40 months. The milk yield for Jersey breed is 5,000 to 8,000 kg, and crossbreed Jersey cow gives around 8 to 10 liter milk per day. In India, this breed has acclimatized well, especially in the hot and humid areas. The second breed of exotic cattle breed is Holstein Friesian. The origin for this breed is the Holland, and the characteristics are they are large, stylish animal with color pattern of black and white or red and white. The Holstein heifers can be bred at 15 months of age when they weigh about 800 pounds. The milk yield for this breed of cattle is around 7,200 to 9,000 kg. And this is by far the best dairy cattle among exotic cattle regarding milk yield, on an average around 25 liter of milk per day. But the crossbreed of this breed will give the only 10 to 15 liter per day. And this breed can perform well in coastal and delta areas. Next is the breeds of buffaloes. First, the indigenous buffalo breeds, in which the first example is Murrah breed, in which most important breed of the buffalo whose home is Rohtak, Hisar and Sindh of Haryana, Nabha and Patiala district of Punjab, and also in the southern part of Delhi state. Otherwise, this breed is also called Delhi, Kundi and Kali. The color, the characteristic is this breed has the color of jet black with white markings on tail and face and extremities sometimes found. It has tightly curved horn is an important characteristic of this Murrah breed, and the most efficient milk and butter fat producer in India, which the milk has contained around 7.83 fat. The average lactation yield is varying from 1500 to 2500 kgs per lactation, and this also used for the grading of the inferior local buffaloes. The second breed in the buffalo is Surti. This breed of buffalo is also known as Deccani Gujarati, Talabda, Charotar and Nadiadi. The breeding tract of this breed is Kera and mainly Baroda district of Gujarat. The characteristic is that the Surti breed of buffalo have coat color varies from rusty brown to silver gray. The horns are sickle shaped, moderately long and flat, and the character of this breed is two white collars, one round the jaw and other at the brisket region. The milk yield is ranges from around 1000 to 1300 kgs per lactation. The peculiarity of this breed is very high fat percentage in milk, that is around 8 to 12 percentage in the milk. Third breed is the Jafarabadi. The breeding tract for this Jafarabadi breed is mainly in Great Forest, Kutch and Jamnagar district of Gujarat. This is the heaviest breed among the all the buffalo breeds. The characteristics are heavy horn, and this udder is well developed to funnel shape, and the milk production for this breed is around 1000 to 1200 kg per lactation. and bullocks of this breed are heavy and they are used mainly for plugging and cutting. And the animals are mainly maintained by traditional breeders called Maldaris, which are the nomads. The next breed is the Bhadwari. The home track of this breed is Agra and Etawah district of Uttar Pradesh and Gwalior district of Madhya Pradesh. This breed of buffalo is medium size and the characteristics are the light or copper color, white line of chewing, and the milk yield of this breed is around 800 to 1000 kg per lactation. These are the good draft animals and the fat content in this milk is around 12.5%. And this breed is efficient converter of coarse feed into butter fat and known for its high butter fat content. The next breed is Nili Ravi. This breed of buffalo is originated from River Ravi and the name Nili Ravi is come from that. This breed is found in Satlej village in Fizopur district of Punjab and also in the Sahiwal of undivided India. The characteristics of this breed is wall eyes. Their head is small, elongate, blugging. Their horns are very small and tightly curled. And bullocks of this breed are good for heavy trotting work. And milk yield of this Nili Ravi breed of buffalo is around 1500 to 1850 kg per lactation. Next is the Mehsani. This breed is mainly found in Mehsana, Sabarkantha and Banaskantha district of Gujarat and also in Maharashtra state. The breed is evolved out of the crossbreeding between Surti and Mura. The body is longer than Mura but limbs are lighter. The horns are less curved. It is the characteristics of Mehsana breed. The bullocks of this breed is heavy work used and the milk yield is around 1200 to 1500 kg per lactation. Next is the Nagpuri. This is also called Elispuri and Barari. And this is from Nagpur, Akola, Amravati district of Maharashtra. The characteristics is they are the black in color with the patches on face, legs and tail. The horns are long, flat and curved and the bullock of this breed is used for heavy work and the milk yield is around 700 to 1200 kg per lactation. The next is the breed of sheep, in which first we will see Indian sheep breeds. The first Indian sheep breed is the Mechari. It is distributed in Salem, Erode, Karur, Namaklal and Darpurun district of Tamil Nadu. It is the meat purpose breed in all of the sheep breed. It has the medium sized body and pale purplish color is their characteristics. They have no horn and tail is very small and slim. The adult male is average body weight is 36 kg and female body weight is around 22 kg. Second is the Chennai Red. It is distributed in the Chennai, Kachapuram, Vilampuram, Thiruvananthapuram district of Tamil Nadu. It is also the meat purpose breed and the characteristic is the they are purple in color and certain animals are color strip on the forehead. The adult male average body weight is 36 kg and female body weight is around 23 kg. The next breed is the Ramananthapuram White. It is distributed in Ramananthapuram, Sivagangai and Virupuram district of Tamil Nadu. This breed is also meat purpose breed and the characteristics of this breed is the medium sized body and they are mainly white in color. The adult male have their bent horn whereas the female with absence of horn and their legs are very small. The average body weight for male is 31 kg and for female is 23 kg. The next is the Kizar Kharaisai. This is the distributed in Ramananthapuram, Sivagangai and Thiruvananthapuram district of the Tamil Nadu. This breed of sheep is also meat purpose breed and the characteristics of this breed is like the medium sized body, color is black red skin and black color bands are found in the skin and their tails is mainly smaller and thin. The adult male are found with the stronger coiled horns. The body weight for male is around 29 kg and for female is around 22 kg. The next breed is Vembur. It is distributed in Mambur, Malakarandi, Kizza Karandai, Nagalampuram region, and also in the Tuticorin and Virudhanagar district of the Tamil Nadu. It is also the meat purpose breed in sheep, and these are the taller breeds. The characteristics of this breed is like white skin color, ears are dropped out, tail are small, and the adult male are found with horns and the absence of horn in case of female. And the body weight for this breed is around 35 kgs for male and around 28 kgs for female. The next is the Nilagiri. These are the distributed in Nilagiri district of Tamil Nadu, and from this the name of Nilagiri will come. It is the wool purpose breed. They are medium weight animals, and the characteristics is they are mainly found in white color, and certain are found with the purple spots on their body and face. The ears are broad and dropped out, and the females are mainly without horns. The average body weight for male is the 31 kg, and for female it is also 31 kg. Next is the Trichy Black. These are distributed in Trichy, Perambalur, Dharmapurai and Salem district of Tamil Nadu. It is all the wool purpose breed of sheep, and these are the smaller breeds, and other characteristics of this breed are the black colored all over the body, and the adult male are found with horns and females are found without horns. The ears are smaller, facing forward and downwards. The adult male average body weight is around 26 kg and female body weight is around 19 kg. The next breed for the sheep is Coimbatore. This breed of sheep is mainly distributed in Coimbatore district of Tamil Nadu, and therefore it is called Coimbatore. It is also wool purpose breed, and they have medium weight. These are the medium weight animal, and the characteristics is the white color also with black or purple color bands seal over the region of head and neck. The 30% of the adult female are free of horns. The body weight for this breed is around 25 kg for male and around 20 kg for female. Next is the exotic sheep breeds, in which the first breed for the sheep is Dorset. This is the native of UK and are lacking horns and horns. The face, ear and legs with white color and the free form wool, it is the characteristics of this breed. And they yield wool on an average 2.75 to 3.75 kg. And they produce the mutton of the superior quality. This is the main characteristics of this breed. And the rams weight around 80 to 110 kg and ewes weight around 50 to 80 kg. And this breed is hardy breed and capable of performing well under most of the conditions. The next example of this breed is the Suffolk. And this is the native of UK and large animal with black face, ears and legs. The head and ears entirely free from wool. There is no wool present all over the body. It is the average wool yield around only 2 to 3 ears. The mature ram weight is around 100 to 135 kg and ewes around the 70 to 100 kg. The ewes are very prolific and excellent milkers. Next breed for the sheep is the Merino. This is the most popular fine wool breed of the world, originated in Spain. It is the white face shape with white feet. It is the characteristics of this breed. The rams have horns, whereas the ewes have no horn. Most of the head and legs are covered by wool. The animal is extremely hardy, willing, able to survive under adverse weather and poor grazing condition. This is the main characteristics. And ewes live and yield longer than any other breed of the sheep. The next example of exotic sheep breed is the Rambouillet. It was developed in France, and it has large head with white hair around the nose and ears, and they have horn. Male have horns and females are hornless. It produces an excellent fine wool fleeces. This is the characteristics of this breed, and the fleeces is heavy, close, compact, covering most of the body including face and also including legs. The next breed is the Chevrolet. It is the medium wool breed primarily developed in Scotland. The breed is small with erect ears, clean white face. It is the characteristics of this breed. Also, the nose, lips and feet are also black. The ram's weight is around 80 kgs and ewe's weight is around 55 kg. The next breed is Southdown. This is one of the oldest English breed and has greatly contributed to the development of many other breed of sheep. The characteristic is that they give the excellent mutton production, and the body is low set, compact, wide and deep with the leg wide apart, and the head is broad and face is light brown color. The ram weight is around 80 kgs and use of this breed is around 55 kg. Next is the breeds of goat. First is Indian goat breeds. First is Jamnapuri. It is mainly found in Uttar Pradesh, and the characteristics is white with back marking neck color, and they have bred in both sexes. It is the largest and long leg goat in India. These are the characteristics of this breed. Next is the beetle. It is found mainly in state of Punjab. These breeds are grown mainly in the purpose of milk and meat. Next is the Barbary. It is short head and erect horn goat popular in the urban areas of Delhi, Uttar Pradesh and other also in Haryana state. These breed are grown mainly for milk and meat purpose. And the characteristics is white color with light brown patches. This is mainly for milk and meat both. Next is the Tellicherry. This breed is also called Malabari breed. It is from Kerala state and this is the meat purpose breed. Next is the breeds of swine. The first is large white Yorkshire. This breed of swine is most extensively used exotic breed in India, and the characteristics is solid white body color, erect ears, snout of medium length and dished face, and this is the excellent breed for the purpose of goat breeding. Second is the Landrace. This breed of swine is white with black skin spot. The characteristics is long body, large dropping ears and long snout. This is the excellent breed for crossbreeding. And the third one is the middle white Yorkshire. It is used in some areas of India. These are grows rapidly, gives good dressing percentage and not so prolific as large white Yorkshire. And the average body weight for male is around 250 to 340 kg and female are for around 180 to 270 kg. Thank you.